Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a weekly budget planner. So the first thing to do is I'm going to turn this page to landscape. So go to layout, orientation, landscape. And I'm just going to zoom in. I'm going to maximize my margins. So again, to layout, margins, click on the drop down, and I'm going to select narrow. It just gives me a little bit more room on the page. Then I'm going to go to insert, table, click on the drop down, and here I'm going to insert 6 columns, and let's go for 8 rows for the time being. Once my cursor is up here in the top left, I'm just going to hit the return key. That allows me the ability to put in a title. I'm just going to hit that a few times. There we go. And I'm going to click back up here. I'm just going to press the center text icon. I'm just going to select it, underline, bold. Just increase using the increase font size tool here. You don't have to do it. You can do it however you want to. Just press the return key again to just push that up. Now, for me, these rows are a bit narrow, so I just want to make them a bit taller. So I'm going to select my table by clicking on this square at the top left, go up to layout, and then in height, I'm going to select all of that and just press 0.8 and press enter. Now, you can expand them a bit more or a bit less if you want to, completely your choice. And then all I'm going to do is, whilst I'm on layout and have my table selected, I'm going to go across to this center or align to center icon here. And that just means that my text, all of the text that I will type, will be in the center of my cells. Now, so what we're going to do is we're going to have the description of our income and then some figures. And I'll show you as we go along how this will pan out. So first of all, we need a title, and I'm going to merge these two cells together. So select them both. Go to layout and click merge cells. I'm going to do that for the next two lots of cells as well. There we go. And in this one, I'm just going to type in income. So in this one, we're going to type in your fixed outgoings. This is like your mortgage, your insurances, things like that. And then we're going to go for the necessary outgoings. That's things like your fuel, your food, that sort of thing. Now, of course, you don't have to do any of this. You can do it exactly how you want to and customize it. I'm just going to show you a really easy and simple technique, which also uses formulas as well, so that you can add it all up at the end. So in your income, you'd put things like salary. Let's say, for example, that's £2,000 or dollars. Let's say you have a pension and so on and so forth. So I'm going to input all of those details and then come back and show you what to do next. Okay, so once we've got all of that added in, I'm just going to add some more cells to really fill the page. And I'm going to do this because it allows us to add things at a later date. So I'm going to place the cursor down here in the lower right cell, and I'm just going to keep pressing the tab key, click in the lower cell again, press the tab key, keep clicking that lower right cell, and go all the way down to the bottom. And then once you create a new page, just press the delete key or press undo, which is Command or Control Z, and then it will just fill that one page. We've just got a one page planner. Obviously, you can take it over two pages if you want to, but for this demonstration, I'm just going to keep it the one page. So at the bottom here, we're going to put your disposable income. And this is basically what you have left after all your necessities have gone out. And here I'm going to put total outgoings because of the way Word works out these formulas. So now what we need to do is add up the totals of all of these columns. Now I'm going to do it right down at the bottom here, because if you want to add things in, then you've got this whole space to do it rather than putting it right next to the last number. So I'm going to select this column here, go to layout, and then select this formula icon here and click. When you click on that, it should come up with equal sum and the word above. Now you can change the word above if you wanted to select things below, to the left, or to the right. But for this demonstration, we want it to be everything above. We can then go down to number format and select the pound sign and then click OK. And as you can see here, we've got the total of everything above. So if I add something else, let's say for example, I added gift and let's put £10 in. You see, if I move away, nothing happens to this number. It should have added that total on. But what you need to do is just select it, go back up to formula. It's got all the information in there, so don't change anything and just click OK. And now you can see that that total has changed. We're going to do the same here. Go to formula, sum above, click on your pound sign, click OK. And again here, formula, pound sign, click OK. Now we've got these totals, I'm just going to select them, go to home, and I'm just going to put them into bold and increase the font size once using this icon here, just to make them stand out that little bit more. Then we come to total outgoings, so select this, and we want to add up this figure here and this figure here. So select this cell here, go to layout, formula. So now instead of summing above to the left or right, we now need to sum the actual cells themselves. So every column and row is allocated a number and a letter. So all the columns are numbered A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and so on and so forth. And all the rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc, etc. So for the first one, we want to put in this cell here. So this is column A, B, C, D. So this is column D. So we put D in. And then row 17. And then we also want to add it to this one here. So I'm just going to put a comma in. And then this is column F and 17 again. Pick the pound sign again and click OK. And there you can see that we've totaled this figure here and this figure here. So now we've got our total outgoings, we want to take this figure from this figure to show our disposable income. So click on this cell here, go back up to formula, and here we're going to do something slightly different for subtracting. We're going to delete all of this, and we're simply going to put the cell in here. So this is column B and 17 down. Then we're going to put in a minus sign, and then for this figure here, we're going to put in column B and then row 18. And then again, pick our pound sign and click OK. And there you have your disposable income. Now when you can come to change any of this, again, let's add something in here. Let's put pet insurance and let's put £100 in. When I put all of these figures in, you can see again, nothing changes. So the first thing we need to do is change this figure here. So go and click on that cell, go to formula and simply click OK. You can see that's now changed. We therefore need to change this figure here again. Formula, OK, that's changed. And again, this one, and this is all just updating it so that it can update those figures. So it's not as intuitive as Excel because obviously all those figures would have changed. But you can do it, you just need to update it manually. Again, I can just select these two figures, go to home and click bold. Now, if you wanted to customize this a little bit further, you can do so. So let's say, for example, we just wanted to exclude these cells here. So I can select them all. I can go to table design, go to borders, and I can select no borders. And then I can just reintroduce the borders here, go to borders, select all borders, select these two here. Again, just click on that now because it's all selected all borders. I can also make things stand out a bit more. So let's select the table up to there. Let's go and pick a thicker border. Let's go down to 2¼, go to borders. And this time I'm just going to select outside borders. And now you can see there's that black border around the outside. We can do that for the top ones as well. So go ahead. Now it's selected and the thicker border selected. All you have to do is just click on it. You don't have to go back and pop all your customizations in. I can do it just for this cell here. just click on that cell, this cell here, and this cell here. Then I can do it for the bottom here, select it all, click borders. So everything you want it to go around, select it and go around those borders you've selected. So let's say I just wanted a border around these four cells and click, it will just go to those four cells. In terms of color, you can select the headings, you can go to shading, and you can click on a color of your choice. So you can shade them if you want to. And I'll go ahead and shade these two as well. There we go. And finally, let's just increase the size of those two figures as well. Perfect. So I hope that's helped you to budget. It certainly does help me. If it has helped, please subscribe and have a great day.